Yeah. तत्र वायुर्गन्धावाहो रणो नासि जिकृषतः
Desiring to smell odors. 想闻气味。
Translation. Therefore, when the Supreme Purusha desired to smell odors, the nostrils and respiration were generated. The nasal instruments and odors came into existence, and the controlling deity of air, carrying smell, also became manifest.
一闻随着当都控制着普鲁萨想要闻气味时，鼻孔和呼吸便产生了，鼻子和气味随即形成。接着负责控制携带气味之空气的绳子也展现了。
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. The nasal instrument, odor, and the controlling deity air, smelling, etc.All became manifested simultaneously when the Lord desired to smell. The Vedic mantras confirm this statement in the Upanishads statement that everything is first desired by the Supreme before the subordinate living entity can act upon it. The living entity can see only when the Lord sees.The living entity can smell when the Lord smells, and so on. The idea is that the living entity cannot do anything independently. He can simply think of doing something independently, but he cannot act independently. This independence in thinking is there by the grace of the Lord, but the thinking can be given shape.By the grace of the Lord. And therefore, the common saying is that man proposes and God disposes. The whole explanation is on the subject of the absolute dependence of the living entities and absolute independence of the Supreme Lord. Less intelligent persons claiming to be on an equal level with God.Must first prove themselves to be absolute and independent, and then they must substantiate their claim to being one with God.
样子由泡发提供。当至尊主想要闻气味时，鼻子、气味、嗅觉和控制这些的神子同时展现出来。奥义书是声明正是说，一切都是由至尊主先有愿望。他属下的生物才能随后去行事，只有当至尊主先看的时候，生物才能看到；至尊主闻的时候，生物里才能闻到气味。要点是，生物体无法独立地做任何事，它只能自己去想做某事，却无法独立地完成。生物体有独立思考的能力，是全凭至尊主的恩典。要想把自己的思想成为现实，只有靠至尊主的恩典才行。正因为如此，常言道：“谋事在人，成事在神。”整个解释的主题是：生物体是有绝对依赖性的，至尊主是有绝对独立性的。声称自己与神处在同一层面的智力强加的人，必须先证明自己是绝对的和独立的，然后必须用实际行动来证明他和神一样。
Today we're hearing about how the sense of smell came into existence.
所以我们今天学的是，也看到这个嗅觉是怎么产生的。
And with the sense of smell, in order to perceive odor, you have to have a nose.
在这个嗅觉器官产生前，我看到这个味觉，闻气味的嗅觉开始展示。
But it's not just the nose, but there has to be also that living force within the body for the nose to be able to perceive smell.
所以我们不仅这个气味是怎么发展的，而里面这个闻着气味的生命力是如何发展。
So it's mentioned also there was a controlling deity for the sense of smell. The controlling deity is air.
所以我们看到这个控制这个味觉的神子是什么？它的指的是这个空气。
So it's not just only having a nose that allows you to perceive smell.
因为你有鼻子才能感觉到这种气味。
There has to be the air to carry the odor.
但是得有空气携带着这个味儿才行。
Just like you pass by a rose garden and the odor of the flowers will be carried in the air.
所以我们就像路过这个玫瑰花园的时候，这个玫瑰花园的芬香，是空气携带的。
Or you pass by a big pile of garbage in the road, and there will be a terrible odor coming from the garbage.
所以路过这个垃圾堆的垃圾箱的时候，那个垃圾里发出那个味道，也是由空气携带出来的。
So the air serves as a vehicle for carrying the odor.
所以这个空气平等的携带不同的味儿，气味。
But we should understand that this whole process of odor having sense of smell, it all originates from the Supreme Lord.
但我们知道，这个气味的携带，这个所有的气味，其实源头都来自于自尊主。
The Lord desired to be able to perceive these different odors.
因为至尊主自己他想感知这些不同的味道。
It is said the odor of the smell of the body of Lord Krishna is kasturi.
What is kasturi?
Kasturi. Kasturi means that's it, the scent of perfume.
这些都来自至尊主身体内的那种perfume, 油。
Krishna's body has the odor of.Kasturi,
因为 Krishna 的身体呀、有一种味道叫 Kasturi 的味道。
Kasturi is a very special odor which is from the body of Lord Krishna.
这个 Kasturi 是至尊主啊身上发出一种特殊的一种味道。
It said also there's Kasturi that you get the Kasturi chemical is in the body of a deer.
这个卡斯杜里来自于这个鹿身上的一种特殊的一个化学的一种成分。
And the deers who live in the Himalayas, they're musk deers. They have this musk, they have this element musk, which is another perfume.
所以居住在喜马拉雅山那个鹿啊，身上发出味道，我们叫麝香。鹿的一种味道叫我们中文叫麝香。
So the deer is always wondering where is the smell coming from.
然后这个鹿就感到特别奇怪，我想这个香味从哪来的呢？
Does not understand the odor is coming from within the body of the deer.
这个鹿本它自己并不明白，这个味道实际来自于自己身体的内部发出来的味道，它自己都不知道。
So here we're hearing about Virata Purush, how the Lord desired to smell.
所以我们看这个诗节中，这个维拉塔普鲁萨说，他想要闻，至尊主想要闻味儿。
And with the desire to smell, then you have the deity, the controlling deity, the air, as well as the nose.
所以他一想，这至尊主要这个愿望，这个控制这个味道、神明啊、空气啊，这都产生出来了。
And it all comes about because the initial desire is coming from the Lord.
之所以产生是来自于至尊主的愿望，他想要闻。
He is the supreme independent person.
因为他是完全至尊独立的人。
Of course, we all want to be independent.
当然，我们大家想独立。
But we are forced to be dependent.
但是我们被强迫的是依靠。
We depend on Lord Krishna.
我们依赖于 Krishna.
We depend on Lord Krishna supplying everything for our maintenance.
我们依靠 Krishna 给我们提供一切来维系。
Without the grace of Lord Krishna, then there will be no water to drink. There will be no air to breathe.
如果没有 Krishna 仁慈，没水喝，也没空气来闻。
Everything is provided by the grace of the Supreme Lord.
一切都有赖于至尊主的仁慈。
And He is the supreme independent being.
因为但他是一个至尊独立的人。
This is described in the very beginning of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
这在国家版的开篇着重描述。
Janmadyasya yato navayat etaritas chateshu abhigyanaswarat. Abhigyanaswarat. It's the very first line of the first sloka of the first chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
国家法坛第一篇第一章第一个诗节第一行讲的这个。
Right? The Lord is described as abhigyana and swarat.That he is absolute and he is independent.
在这个世界讲，这个比如说，我是独立的，我也是
absolute
绝对的，至尊的，还是独立的。
We are not absolute. We are dependent on the supreme.
我们可不是绝对的，我们是完全依靠至尊的。
Right? We are part and parcel of the Lord.
我们是主的所属部分。
We have a relationship with him.
我们跟他有关系。
One in quality, different in quantity.
在品质上如一样的，在数量上差距大了。
So the Lord is supremely independent.
所以至尊主是至尊完全独立的生物。
And sometimes, of course, we also try to be independent.
我们在某种上是想要独立。
We are thinking ourselves to be the doer.
我们自己认为我们自己是行为者。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Pratyate kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvashaha ahankara vimudatma kartaham iti manyate. The bewildered spirit soul.Thinks himself to be the doer of activities which are carried out by the modes of nature.
这个奎山在《国家房屋》中提到 ，Prakriti kriya kamani guna kamara sambandha hamka vibhuta kamaka kanti jmanyate. 假我的影响是困惑的灵魂，以为自己是活动的作为者，殊不知活动实际上是由物质之间三形态履行的。
We are thinking we are the doer. We did it, but actually we didn't do anything.
我们认为自己是作为者，这是都是我做的。实际上我们啥也没做。
It's all done through the modes of nature.
全是物质自然在做。你做了什么呢
？And the modes of nature are under the control of the supreme Lord.
而物质自然呢，处在至尊主的控制下。
The modes of nature are personified by Mother Durga.
而这个物质自然的人格呢，就是母亲 Durga.
And she moves like a shadow under the direction of the supreme Lord.
她的就像一个至尊主的指导者下的一个影子而已。
So we have to understand our connection with the supreme.
所以我们大家应该明白，我们跟贵至尊主是有关联的，有关系。
That we are dependent on him.
我们依赖于他。
We are not independent.
我们不是独立的，想干什么就干什么。
But out of ignorance, sometimes a living entity thinks that he is independent.
但有的时候出于愚昧无知。生物认为我是独立的，都我干的。
Our position is like little sparks coming from the fire.
我们都被比为来自于火中的一个火星。
Right? The Lord is like a burning fire.
主好比熊熊燃烧的大火。
And the living entities are compared to tiny sparks of light which come from the fire.
而生物被比喻为一些渺小的火花，而来自那个熊熊燃烧的大火。
So these sparks which come from the fire, if they fall into contact with water, they will be extinguished.
而这个渺小的火星离开了大火，掉到水里熄灭。
But if they fall, if they can fall in contact with dry grass.Then they can ignite another fire.
如果这个火星掉到了干柴中，它又再次成为一个熊熊的烈火。
So the living entity, if it falls into association with materialistic, with the material world, he will become forgetful of his spiritual identity. His spiritual nature will be covered.
如果这个生物受来到物质自然的物质世界的控制下。他会遗忘了自己的灵性的身份。
But if he contacts the association of devotees, then his spiritual nature can be brightened.
忘记了物质的灵，物质和忘记了灵性的本性，当他与奉献者联谊的时候，他的灵性本性开始复苏。
The living entity has independence to choose to Krishna or to surrender to mind.
所以这个生物的这个选择就是，它是一想依靠归生，还是想依靠妈呀
？That is as far as our independence goes. No more independence after that.
但除此之外，一点独立性都没了。选择完以后，独立性。
Surrender to Krishna, then we come under the control of Krishna's spiritual energy.
如果你选择归生。那你就处在 Krishna 的灵性能量的控制之下。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Mahatmanas tumam parta devim prakritim ashrita. Is that the devotees are under the protection of my divine energy?
Krishna 在佛家梵文中说，Mahatma tumam parta devim prakritim ashrita啊。会上说，伟大的灵魂不受蒙蔽，受神性的保佑。
那 Krishna says, the devotees are under the protection of the divine energy.
会上说，我的奉献者在我神圣能量的保护下。
That means we will be engaged in going to devotional service.
那就意味着我们从事会上的奉献服务。
Just like in the temple here.You're engaged in, you're under the protection of Krishna's divine energy.
就像我们大家在这个庙，我们这个庙就处在 Krishna 的神圣能量的保佑之下。这个庙。
We only eat prasada.
我们只吃 prasada.
We only chant Hare Krishna and hear about Krishna.
我们只唱 Hare Krishna, 聆听 Hare Krishna.
We're only engaging in devotional service here.
我们在这只从事于对 Krishna 的服务。
And there's no influence of the material energy.
我们就不受到物质能量的影响了。
But if we surrender to Maya, we choose to surrender to Krishna's external energy, Maya, we come under the control of the modes of nature.
但一旦我们选择了受到非常外在能量 Maya 的这个情况下的话，我们就受到物质之言形态的控制和影响。
Goodness, passion, and ignorance.
第三形态就是善良、激情、愚昧的影响啊。
And most of it's passion and ignorance.
多数是受到激情和愚昧的控制和影响。
Little glimpses of goodness sometimes appear.
有的时候有一点点善良的缺失。
But most of the time, passion and ignorance.
大部分时间除了愚昧就是激情。
So living entities' independence is very small.
所以我们那种独立性啊，看一看，多小，小的可怜。
We are thinking we're independent.
我们想我是独立的。
We make great efforts to maintain our position.
我们尽最大的努力保持我们的现在的地位。
But everyone is defeated by the material energy.
但每个人都实际上受到物质自然能量的踢打。
There were so many great men in history.
在历史上有那么多的大人物。
But they were all defeated in the course of time.
但是他们都被时间所击败。
武则天 Friend, she thought she was supreme.
她认为自己是至尊。
She thought she could control the material nature.
她认为自己能控制物质自然。
She ordered the flower, the mudan flower, to open.
她命令牡丹花，你给我开花。
And when it didn't open, get out of my kingdom.
她命牡丹没花，没听她的话，离开了。 把这个牡丹花给我逐出我的王国，给我赶出去。
But she was defeated ultimately by the material thing.
所以她自动的被物质自然所击败。
So how to overcome this material energy?
那么如何控制克服物质自然呢？
So that is explained by Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita.
这个由慧上在佛家梵文中告诉大家已经讲了。
The material nature is very difficult to overcome. But if you surrender to me, then you can easily cross beyond.
慧上在佛家法会所，这三种物质资源组成的能量难以克服，但自愿臣服的人却能轻易跨越。
So surrender to Lord Krishna helps us. It's the only way to get out from this material energy.
所以自愿臣服慧上。 是我们超越物质能量的唯一的方法，唯一的道路。Material
energy is like the tar baby. There's a story about the tar baby.
Tar baby.
Tar. You know, tar is very sticky. You touch the top, you can't get free. Can't get
顽固。物质世界就好比是一个顽固的小孩儿。
雕刻的孩子，就你这个雕刻的孩子，你怎么碰它，它就没反应，没法动。但你想用这个手动了，它动不了；你想用那个手的话，你两只手都被控制住了。
就像那种粘黏剂的，就你一碰它，你就被粘上，你这个手都去碰的话，这孩子啊，就是粘合剂嘛，都被粘上，你怎么想逃脱？但你要用那种用力，想让这个手或者自由，想松开这个手。但它那个。 东西已经让你粘住了，没法活动。Material energy
is like that.
就物质能量就像这种情况。We try to get
free, but we just get more entangled.
我们想努力的挣脱物质能量，你越挣脱越深陷其中。We're
thinking we're getting free, but we're getting deeper and more entangled.
我们认为我们获得了解放和自由，实际上我们越来越深的被陷在了这个物质能量里。
The only way we can get out from the material energy is by taking shelter of the controller of the material.
唯一摆脱这个物质这个限制的唯一的方法，就是你脱离于这个能量的控制者。
So surrender needs to recognize that we are under the protection of Lord Krishna.
所以自愿臣服就意味着自愿地受到了Krishna的保护。
And He is the maintainer.
他是维系者。
We are not doing anything.
我们做不了啥事。
The Prabhupada quotes, he says, man proposes and God disposes.
所以Prabhupada在要中说，谋事在人，成事在神。
All depending on the Supreme Lord.
我们完全依赖于至尊主。We
have to learn what to propose and how to approach the Lord.
所以我们应该学会如何谋事，什么是谋事在人，我们如何谋是为了接近会上。
We want to become, we want to express our dependence on the Lord.
我们还要表达出我们是完全依靠会上。
But at the same time, we want to have the mode of servant.
同时我们还要有服务的心态。
We don't just come to take from the Lord, we want to give.
我们不是到会上那儿去拿东西，你得给会上点东西。
What do we have to give?
我们能给啥？
The Lord has everything himself. He has all the fruits. He has all the flowers.
会上啥都有，那花那水果他应有尽有，你能给他啥？
He has all beautiful ladies there serving him.
他旁边有老鼻子漂亮的女士在伺候他，需要你吗？
But he wants our devotion.
但是会上要我们的奉爱。
He wants our loving devotion.
他们要我们的爱心服务。
This is described in the Bhagavad Gita.
这在《薄伽梵文》中有描述。
Bhaktyaparampuram palamtoyam yome bhaktyaprayachati tadaham bhaktiyuparitam ashnami prayatam. Lord is saying, you can offer him leaf, flower, fruit, water.But these things must be offered with love and devotion. So the Lord has many fruits and flowers from all the goddesses of fortune.But he wants the devotion.
当然，会上会从幸运女神那里得到大量的什么花水果，但是会上也想从他的奉献者那里得到花和水果。
That is the proper use of our dependence.
这就是对自己independent.
We show our dependence to Lord Krishna.
对，这样我们向会上展示我们是多么的依靠他。
By offering with love and devotion.
通过供奉我们的爱和奉爱来展示我们的对他的依赖。
Okay, any question?
大家有什么问题吗？
Krishna doesn't stand with a big stick and say, you love me or else.
不是会上拿个大棍子逼着你，你必须爱我，我爱我受着你。会上怎么拿个棍子？
You don't want to love Krishna, you don't want to serve Krishna, okay.
如果你不想爱会上，如果你不想服会上 okay, 可以拿棍子。
Go back to your little home
去回你那个小家去吧，小窝里去。你爸说滚吧。
We have these two energy, material energy and spiritual energy. And as a devotee, we are trying to practice Krishna consciousness so that we can utilize this material energy to serve Krishna. And we use our body to do a lot of practices, especially chanting. Sometimes we wake up in the morning and chant. But somehow or other, sometimes we felt very tired because actually when we practice spiritual and physical activity, we're supposed to get more energy. So what this cause, is it any kind of situation why we can become tired and even though we have rested enough?
When something happens, you know, maybe somebody brings in a big plate of prasada, very delicious, nice prasada, you don't feel so tired
anymore. 给自己撑累了是吧？吃多就累了是吧？
It's our conditioning really, it's our own state of consciousness which is the problem.
还取决于我们受条件限制，有的时候我们的知觉也是个问题，知觉的问题。
When somebody comes along and agitates you and makes you angry, then you don't feel so tired anymore.
有人来攻击你了，骂你，让你特别生气，这个时候你一点都感到不累。别人骂你是一点都不累，看，可精神
了。We're battling with the mind constantly.
这实际上是我们自己心意的造成的问题。
We come to chant Hare Krishna every morning, we sit down and.
就我们来早上来坐下来念一念诵念还是非常一念哦太累了可累了
And when you open Srimad Bhagavatam you say Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya and everyone goes to sleep
然后你打开国家马台一听说 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya 你看开睡那家睡得特多
Mukshadela Vijaya
那我们一游啊沙利拉比加加没一个睡的全醒了可精神了感冒绿光了 你能做得到。
Some people do it only take a moment.
有人在片刻就做到，片刻。
That Vanga Maharaj is only a moment.
他的 Vanga Maharaj 用一片刻就回去了。
My respiration had 7 days.
把人家的 Maharaj 用7天时间就回去了。
Became very serious.
因为什么？人家是真诚，人家真求。
So, how old are you now?
你今年贵庚啊？多大年纪？你今年？
55。So half of your life is over.
你人生的一半已经过去了。
You have to prepare for the next life.
你们要为你下辈子做好准备啊！
You have to become very serious.
意味着你一定要认真修了，可别玩了。
Maharaj, the old
35 years old. She is younger than me. I'm too old. So what to do? Well, you're doing the right thing by coming here and being with us and chanting and taking part in the program.
你通过来这儿和我们在一起唱诵跳舞。 你正在做正确的事儿。 所以你正在做正确的事情， 用正确的机会来提高你的知觉， 正在提高你的知觉。
So you have to continue, you have to keep up your spiritual practice.
你就继续这么做， 好了，保持你这个灵性的进步。 你这样做就是保持你的灵性进步。
所以你继续保持那种知觉去活动，那你下辈子就跟Chris一起混了，跟Chris在一起了。那我明年还来吗？欢迎你，欢迎你，马六甲欢迎你。
马马丽丽，他说你明年你自己一个人也可以来，不用报名。
I think you have to also thank Mr. Sakti Mantanji for such great organizing, bring all the people here, to make sure everyone is all looked after. So maybe you all can replace her and let her be a someone come and then someone take a leadership role. That will be easier. 我们应该谢谢感恩那个上帝马大利带动，感恩你带着你张总来，你导他们来，谢也很一定很烦恼的。所以呢，如果明年他不要领导，他可以来，你们其他的领导哦，也可以来嘛，是不是？这领导不是容易的，要你们要住的地方啊，吃的啊，什么要得到嘛。
我们这个是辛苦，是。So I don't feel very tired.
Thank you.
Yeah.